The other day, I ended up covered in earthworm juice. Let me tell you how I got there. I was just looking for ants under rocks, like any normal person does on a weekend, when I realized that there was a big, big, massive earthworm. It started moving forward, I think, or backward, maybe forward. I really had no idea, so I decided to do what any good scientist would do. Take a stick and turn that earthworm upside down and try to find a head. So let's have a look at the inside of an earthworm. This is what you see when you cut an earthworm in two halves. The center of the body is a big cavity that is filled with water, but also all the body wastes of the worm and the gases that's inside. So when the earthworms want to move, they use this as a bone actually. And when they get stressed, or if it's too dry outside, or if they have trouble breathing, or if it's too hot, or if they just don't like their face, they contract their body segments to eject the fluid out of the body. And this particular species of earthworm is a champion in this category. This species is Didymogaster sylvaticus. It is also known as the Australian blue squirting earthworm. It can spray liquid to up to 30 centimeters away from its body. So I named it Bert, gave it some water to compensate for the loss of the coelomic fluids, and I put his house back in place. If you like this video and want to see more animals like Bert the squirting earthworm, please subscribe to this channel.